There's 104 days of summer vacation, and school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way to spend it.
Like maybe
building a rocket, or fighting a mummy, or climbing up the Eiffel Tower. Discovering something that doesn't exist, hey! Or giving a monkey a shower. Surfing tidal waves, creating nanobots, or locating Frankenstein's brain.
It's over here!
Finding a dodo bird, painting a continent, or driving her sister insane.
Scoopers!
As you can see, there's a whole lot of stuff to do before school starts this fall.
Come on, Barry!
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all. So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all.
Rocio, the Scoopers are making a title sequence.
Here and we're back with Juanis, and today we're going to be talking about the importance of originality.
Being original in our society has become something extremely difficult. Every day we're scared of being judged.
And sadly, we're actually being judged all the time by everyone. We are being judged through social media, we're being judged by the people that are close to us, our family, our friends, and being judged is something that scares us, and that of course it matters to us and it hurts.
Yeah, and it's funny because every day we hear these motivational words that we're telling you today. You need to be different, you need to be unspecial, and however, we don't apply them. However, it's really important for us to understand that it's true. Those words that nowadays sound cheesy are real. Our difference makes us special.
It is really important that each one of us understands that all the flaws that we may have are the one thing that makes us different from the rest, and the one thing that instead of making them seem like a problem, we should embrace them. We need to learn how to embrace our flaws and make them the beautiful part of ourselves.
So girls, embrace yourself. We hope you receive this message and apply it.
Since Women's Day is celebrated internationally in March, we decided to bring to you, in a very brief way, the stories and accomplishments of two women who were ignored by history. The first woman is Cecilia Payne. Cecilia Payne was a British-American scientist and astronomer who was born in the UK in the 1900s and died in 1979. Her biggest contribution to science was an explanation for the composition of stars in the terms of the relative abundance of hydrogen and helium. She also established that stars could be classified according to their temperature. Payne showed how to decode the complicated spectra of starlight in order to learn the relative amounts of chemical elements in the stars. In 1960, the distinguished astronomer Otto Struff referred to this work as the most brilliant PhD thesis ever written in astronomy.
Simone de Beauvoir was a French philosopher, writer, and professor. She was a fighter for women equal rights. Her thoughts are framed in the philosophical current of existentialism, and her work, The Second Sex, is considered fundamental in the history of feminism. Simone, for the first time, stated that the role of men and women were born of social construct, which is something that society has created and imposed. She also stated that women don't need to be parents if they didn't wish to be, and that they are not obligated to dedicate themselves to raising children at home, but that they were free to choose the same opportunities as men.
Here come some fun facts. Did you know that on March 10, 1876, Alexander Graham Bell made the first phone call ever when he called his assistant and said something like, "Mr. Watson, come here, I want to see you"? Or did you know that some famous people born in this month include the painter Vincent van Gogh, the actor Daniel Craig, or the singer Justin Bieber?
March was originally the first month of the Roman calendar, and it was named after the Roman god of war, Mars. On March 15, 44 years BC, Julius Caesar was assassinated in the Senate chamber in Rome. This assassination was led by Marcus Junius Brutus. Coca-Cola was first developed on March 29, 1886.
Cultural Colombian questions to the teachers for two.
The name of Colombia refers to the Spanish Hernán Cortés, true or false?
False.
What are three large Native American families living in Colombia in 15th century?
Chichas, Araguacos, Aguayun, I don't know.
Wow. Okay. Who founded Santa Marta, the capital of Department Magdalena in Colombia?
Paz.
What are six natural regions of Colombia?
Natural regions? Paz.
The name of Bogotá's airport?
El Dorado. Mm-hmm.
What Colombian wrote the famous romantic novel María?
Oh, I should know that, but I don't.
What has been the only Colombian literary award that Cervantes and Príncipe de Asturias awards?
The only Colombian?
Yeah.
Author?
Uh-huh.
That has to be Marquez, no?
Uh-huh. What is the national flower of Colombia?
Orchid.
What is Colombia's main seaport?
Buenaventura.
What was the first colony in the Americas located in the current territory of Colombia?
No sé, Cartagena.
In which municipality is the waterfall of Tequendama Falls?
Cundinamarca.
What is the largest lake in Colombia?
Guatavita.
Who founded the city of Santa Fe in Bogotá?
Gonzalo Jiménez de Quesada.
What is the most widely circulating newspaper in Colombia?
El Tiempo.
Bye, have a good day. Doctor!
Yes?
A dog? A horse? A cow?
Okay, good.
Bye. You're a veterinarian?
Oh my god, yes.
Yeah.
Good. A parrot?
No.
A bird?
I know, a chicken!
Hi girls! Welcome to the second edition of The Scoopers on the Street.
Today we're gonna ask some questions to the girls of TNT.
Name three books you have read this year.
The Handmaid's Tale, The Picture of Dorian Gray, and Ensayo sobre la Ceguera.
Great.
Name three science teachers, including physics and chemistry.
Julito, Ana Milena, Lorena.
Name three sisters from the school.
Sister Margaret, Sister Carolina, Sister Valerie.
Seven. Great.
This was Scoopers on the Streets. Suriya puriya pili biri buda, suriya puriya pili biri buda, suriya puriya pili biri buda, jum dim dim.